Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Hard Reset. As per usual, I'm just going to go ahead and jump here in the cutscene, and we will continue from there.
I just wonder why the fuck they ordered me to destroy this shit. They can use a lot of this data themselves.
They are sure they already have it. Nevertheless, they have only what I wanted them to have.
You all are such geniuses when it comes to feeding shit to your fellows.
Disinformation is an effective weapon. Observe this monument, Major. Do you happen to know what it is?
Atlas. A titan carrying the heavens.
This is correct. However, in this situation, the statue is a different symbol from Greek mythology. A Trojan horse.
I don't get it.
The Trojan horse was insidiously used by the Greeks to conquer the impregnable city of Troy.
I know what a Trojan horse is. What does it have to do with this?
Look at the data. The machines are careful. I managed to unravel this. Billions of nanomachines have been constructing something inside the Atlas for years. Security monitoring has undetected these subtle changes in its structure. The corporation is unaware of this threat.
And let's keep it that way. Time to blow shit up.
Wonderful. One problem. The Atlas is an extraordinary machine. Although the Atlas is part of the exterior AI, it is also partially autonomous. They have designed a method to compile all the data from its AI matrix.
The hell? If you think...
Major, this is the only possible way. We have to learn the exterior AI's plans. However, reading the AI matrix will have some side effects. It will devastate the quantum entanglements, thus scrapping the matrix.
The clock is ticking. It's time, Professor.
So apparently we're terrorists now. I don't know.
Capacitate the Atlas and retrieve the data from its remains.
Okay. So apparently we gotta fight this Atlas robot, but I have a railgun, so I'm not particularly worried about it. We'll poke around a little bit. See how many obvious secrets we can find. Which actually brings me to last video's comment. Nighthammer made a really interesting comment there. And you guys should go check it out. It's really fascinating, and it makes a lot of sense. Seriously. Invisible walls game, like... Ugh. Terrifying. Oh, they came sooner than I had expected. Seriously, dude? Seriously, dude? My god. Those things, those are probably the only enemy in this game thus far that I have legitimate dislike for because they are just so robust. They just refuse to go down. This is a total waste of ammo. I love it. I don't even care. It's like, ammo is common enough. I'm not particularly worried. Especially since we have some recharge going on. Okay, there's some health over there. And some health right here. And some experience! And it's not a secret. I'm amazed. We are still sitting on those two levels from last time. So I don't know... how long they're gonna wait to throw a... Oh, what are they called? One of the little upgrade pods at us. Alright. Thanks for your hint there, Doc, but I think I got this. I have a railgun, if you haven't noticed. Well, there's... That was interesting. You can watch a thing just disappear out of game space. Okay. Alright. Are they all just coming from down here? Because if they are, well, you guys know how this goes. I believe we are all familiar with this particular song and dance. The glory of AoE. I think they're dead. Go ahead and collect the Gibbs. I do think it's kind of clever how they work the armor, or not the armor, the energy and stuff, that in such a way that enemies can just kind of randomly drop it without being like, these enemies drop, you know, bullets. It's your weapons, you know, you're dropping energy off of robots. That makes sense. Activate the forklift to clear the way. But seriously? Okay, that's a little ridiculous. Like, oof, that is some lazy level design right there. An invisible wall, just to keep me from being able to... Wow. That's... I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed. Because that's pretty weak. Is there anything? No? Okay. Figured I'd check. Oh, hey, quick save. Thanks for that. Oh, I hear one of the biggins. I heard one of the biggins. Oh, yeah, there's one of the... two of the biggins. What are biggins? Uh-oh. My hit points. Oh no. Yeah, I'm dead. I am so in trouble. Get out of my way. Like this. Not good. I managed to squeak my way out of that somehow, but like seriously, you're just gonna throw me in a little corner there and not let me get out. That's kinda rough. Seriously? No. No, you don't. No. Sit your evil robot ass right down. Okay. I got my goodies over here. We might hit three levels before we find an actual upgrade thing. Oh. Alright, I'll play your game. What do we got? Sure, why not? Secret found. Oh, hey. Oh, they can charge through terrain too. And once more, I am just kind of stuck in a corner. Jeez. I do not like those guys. I'm not even gonna mince words about it. They are a threat. They are, sadly, probably the only enemy I've fought in this game that I actually consider, you know, a legitimate threat. I didn't get myself stuck back there, did I? But seriously though, I want an upgrade station, dang it. I'm like sitting on the cusp of three levels here. It's been too long. So you don't need that. I'm just kind of poking around. See if there's any health laying around. I wouldn't say I'm desperately low. Yeah, that's what I figured. But I would kind of like some extra hit points. The game is not seeing fit to grant them, however. That's okay. I'll get through by player skill. Ha! Ha! Hey, another upgrade. That's three. Alright. I'm sure I can't just do this. No, because I can't get off those tracks. Oh. Okay. Like, this just... it just seems like a bad idea. I mean, alright. There. Okay, this railgun is just opening up so much stuff. It makes me wonder what you're supposed to do if you've got the... what in the heck? If you've got the physical guns. Like, if you're working on those, is there... there's gotta be, like, an equivalent. You were supposed to return to HQ. I've gone rogue.
Ignore them, Mr. Fletcher. You are off duty now.
Hey, you gotta get Mr. Fletcher talking here with his generic action hero voice. I'm a badass and I know it. I starred in the PG-13 action flick, Time Cop. Back to action. I don't know. I don't even know where I was going with that. I don't really need this, considering I know he's probably like right about there. Oh, there we go. Oh, he's trying, I'm juking. Ooh, messy. The environmental kills are pretty satisfying, I'm not gonna lie. Like, honestly, this game does not play badly, I will give it that. It's incredibly cliched in pretty much every way possible, storyline-wise, but I guess when you're playing a shooter like this, you're not really in it for the story, are ya? You're just kind of in it to do what I'm doing, run around and shoot things. This is like the B-movie of video games right here. This is not a video game, folks. This is a video game, V-I-D-J-A. You can tell by, you know, the fact that it's probably in reality about 5 hours long. Okay, so that's certainly a random exhaust port. Okay, I'm not gonna question it. It can be there and do whatever it does. But seriously though, I'd really like an upgrade station game if you would, you know, kindly give me a place to spend my damn levels. Unless I've hit a point where I no longer get upgrade points, in which case I'm gonna be kind of perturbed. And that shotgun is still, like, this thing is just so bad. I don't even know, like, legitimately what it's, because it doesn't kill things fast enough. That's the problem with it. It's like, okay, it's a shotgun. I like shotguns. They're typically, like, my go-to gun in shooters. I love them. And they give me a shotgun here that the whole point of a shotgun is it one-shots things because, you know, pellets or whatever. And here, shotguns are like, I mildly annoy things via low-grade electrocution. I wonder if I can just tap things to death without using ammo. It's not working too good, is it? I mean, look at that. It's ridiculous. I'm gonna get myself killed here if I'm not too careful. Seriously, guys. Anybody else? I'm sitting at 6 health because I was sitting there playing with the shitty shotgun. There's some health up there. Or not some health. Oh no, there's some health up there. Sweet. I was gonna say some experience up here, not health. Oh, that looks like a full heal. Oh, 80. Only 80 of my 100 hit points. I also appreciate that your health doesn't regen. I like that I have the shield. And that's actually one thing. I hate shooters that have regenerating health, but I like shooters that have, you know, you have health and then you have a, like, an overshield. And that is one thing that I will give Halo, the original Halo, some pretty decent credit for, was bringing that idea to shooters. It's a shame that all of the companies ran with it to just, you know, turn it into the boring regenerating health system, but that is one credit that I will give the original Halo. My friends know this, I am not a huge Halo fan. I don't think it did anything super, super innovative beyond, you know, I guess the... Are these things shooting fire? Ow! Oh, Jesus! I don't think it really did too much to innovate. I mean, that's not fair. I don't think it did too much to innovate the shooter genre. Overload the generator circuits, explosions will clear the path. All right. I do think it brought a lot to console shooters, but I don't know how people play shooters on consoles. I am just so bad at them. After playing with mouse and keyboard for my entire life, it's just, it feels like I might as well be playing left-handed. I'm trying to blow this damn thing's arm off. There we go. All right, he's down. This guy, I know that they have shields on his arm. Well, on his right arm, anyways. Ow. Maybe on all of his arms. Come on. Seriously? My god! Those things are just insanely durable. It's maddening. I don't, like, yeah. I got nothing. I'm bitching. I'm getting a little salty here. Alright, so what are my assets in this area aside from not many? Alright, so where's the big one at? There's the big one. I'm gonna slow him down. I'm not too worried about that other one. This big guy, though, you can just kind of... God. And this game, it's so badly... I think it would be so much more enjoyable to play if it had a freaking dodge mechanism to it. Like, give me my double tap dodging, damn it. And the combat would be really good, I think. I mean, it's not bad now. It just... Ow? Oh, he wasn't dead. I thought that thing was dead. I don't even know. Stuff's just exploding now. Anyways, I do think that there could be some refinement here, but overall it's pretty satisfying to play. The explosions are certainly pretty, I'll give it that. See anything? Oh, we've got some fire. Oh, can I just... Yeah, I can just jump over it, okay. Go ahead and take that. Wow, 4 levels. Getting a little ridiculous here, game. That's trouble coming for me right here. Well, that's the only way they can come, so naturally the good old-fashioned mortar wall goes into effect. Go ahead and have a look-see. And this thing actually letting me see through walls is actually surprisingly helpful, because I can, like, pop over to it from other weapons and be like, is there anything coming for me? And if there is, you know, I can prepare for it. Okay, I'm gonna grab this. So we are pretty well set. I will say that I don't know if I want to say that the game's kind of too forgiving when it comes to ammo and health and stuff, because it seems like you go from full ammo to no ammo pretty quickly, and if you're not careful, you go from full health to dead pretty quickly too. Okay. But seriously though, game, I demand a leveling kiosk. Oh, we've got another one of these dudes. Hey there, buddy. I'm not even gonna blow that rocket pad off of his back. Rocket pod, I should say. Just making sure I don't have anything else chasing me around here. These guys, I honestly don't think are too particularly threatening. That's why I'm just kind of like trolling him here a little bit. Let's see if I can knock this thing off. It does not appear that I can. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start actively trying to kill him now. Sorry, buddy. You hulking meat beast. Oh, that was messy. Okay, here we go. No, but seriously though. So you get a rocket launcher. Okay, and proximity mines. What in the... Okay, that was an interesting sound effect. Oh, yeah, I believe I wanted to grab... Let's see, shell emitter. Shield booster. Not too worried about that. I want... extra ammo. But... it appears that pickups regenerate more ammo. Okay, so we'll get this. And that's like all we've got, I guess. Shield boost, max shield capacity increase. That might be worthwhile. Yeah, let's fuss with our gun, and we'll go from there. Okay, so this thing's terrible, I'm never gonna use it. This guy, yeah, I'll take faster recharge. Smart gun. Homing energy projectiles. I don't really have too much trouble aiming. So I guess we'll increase the AoE of our grenades. Okay. And here, I'm gonna go with the shield emitter for some additional shields. Okay, so we're done. There you go, 4 levels in the blink of an eye. 4 levels in like, I don't know, probably 2 minutes. I'm curious how high our shields go. Maybe 150? 125? Better not be 120 or I'm gonna be pissed. Oh yeah, the speedier reload on this, you shit, is definitely, definitely appreciated. Anybody else? No? No. All right, No, I can definitely notice the expedited regen. I do suppose I could pick up a couple upgrades for some of my normal firearms too as backups. Rocket launchers are tempting. Go ahead and disable this. Whoa, hey there. The quick saves are always so jarring when they happen. Alright, they have not noticed me yet. Seriously, game? What are you gonna make me do to get over there? Seriously, I don't even know. Alright, where are they coming at me from? Alright, so it's just these guys. I'm not too particularly worried. I love it. Like, that... It's cool, you know? You don't see guns like... I haven't seen a railgun that actually lets you shoot through and see through walls like this since Red Faction. And everybody bitched about that because, oh my god, it's so overpowered! And screw that, it's clearly the best gun ever made. And you would think that if you have a gun that can shoot through walls that it would naturally come with the ability to see through them so that, you know, you can efficiently target things with it. Just saying. Okay, what are we looking at? Just the one? Alright. That wasn't too bad. Boo. No after combat gibbing. Slight disappointment. Okay. Got that. Some extra XP. Some more XP. Nanites, whatever it's supposed to be. It's experience points. I don't even care. I'm sure I'm driving someone insane by saying that, but you know, it's experience points. Just what else is it gonna be? Money? I suppose it could be money. It's experience points. I'm the one playing this. I say it's experience points. I'm a professional. Deal with it. Can I get up here? Oh man, like that's another thing that the environments are, you know, interesting in this, and I want to be able to kind of jump around on them and stuff, but the game doesn't allow it. Probably because the AI wouldn't be able to get up to them, which I suppose, you know, since they're not throwing all ranged enemies at you, that I could see definitely putting a bit of a chink in things. Okay, so we have some ammo, which I don't actually need. So... So drunk. I'm backtracking. Screw it. Because I don't know when the next of those freaking stations is gonna be. They made me wait so long for this last one. That ain't happening again. I wanna spend it. I'm gonna upgrade my machine gun. I think I mentioned this a couple episodes. I keep wanting to call this thing a Gep gun, which is from Deus Ex. And I think the closest thing to a Gep gun in this would actually probably be the RPG. I honestly can't remember what the Gep gun did in Deus Ex. I think it was like a rocket launcher. But I might be wrong. Okay. So what can I do with this thing? A grenade launcher or a shotgun? Well, what can I do with this? A scope or a turbo engine? I'm going with the turbo engine just to kind of put out more hurt. So how are we looking? I don't know. Okay. That works. I don't know. It's basically my fallback gun, so I'm not gonna invest a whole heck of a lot into it. If they let me pick up the RPG without investing a ton, oh yeah, you bet your butt I'd be, you know, throwing points into that. But they don't, so I'm really not going to. Go ahead and grab that. Because we totally need 240 ammo to replace the 10 we used. I don't know. Okay. So we're back to where we ought to be. Oh, ha! Oh, I bet I'm gonna get bitched at about that one. Deal with it. Professional, etc., etc. Oh, this is giving me feelings of possible boss fight. That is not what I wanted to do. Switch me back to my railgun. There we go. He may live. Oh, did... No. Okay, so where... I gotta know. Like, if I just kind of saturate the area with railgun fire. If I... Okay. Oh. Jeez. I hate these guys. Hate. Let me tell you how much I hate you. That's right, I'm quoting Am from frickin' I Have No Mouth and I Must Scream now. My hate is so great for them. Although that actually went pretty smoothly. It would seem that possibly laying down the stasis field and then unloading on them is probably the wiser course of action in dealing with them. Okay, anything up here? No. There's some statuary. I don't know. Hey there, little cleaner bot. You just keep on keeping on. Okay, so I'm gonna guess that that's probably the way we have to go to continue plot and, well, I'd progress the game. I'll say that and say, I was hoping that I could get through there. Maybe I can. Do I just have to blow those up? No. No weapons allowed. Sorry. Guess that that's kind of a no-go right there. Oh, let's see. Now kill them all. Kill them all. Well, here. Yeah, that'll kill them all. Whoa. Uh-oh. Nope. Nope. Oh, come on. I went to do that, and for some reason the game was like, no, you don't get to activate your stasis field for whatever reason. I got nothing. How are we looking? Alright, that's all of them. Now that I have thoroughly saturated the area in electro-mortar rounds, I don't know. I don't know. Just give me bullets and XP and whatever else is back here. That actually looks like it? They can't be. This is the only way we could go. Unless, oh, I missed something. Ha ha ha! What else is new? Disable. Okay. Strange. I will grab this ammunition because I need it. Oh, okay, so there's Atlas. This, yeah, I was gonna say, this kind of smells like a boss fight. Wonder if it's the final boss. We're only on episode 5, though. It can't be the final boss. I think there's at least, maybe there are only 5 levels. I don't know how many levels there are. I'm not gonna worry too much about it. I'm gonna go ahead and plop that down there because there's a bunch of those little exploding fart boxes running around. Hey there, bud. Electromagnetic AoE death for you, and you, and you, and you. Okay, I gotta know. I wanna know if the ads respawn, because these are the only real threats, and there's only 2 of them. And if the ads don't respawn, like, honestly, I would say that the little roly exploding ball enemies are more dangerous than these guys are. Because with these guys, I mean, as you can see, it's just kind of circle strafe to victory. Ammo. It would appear that, yeah, maybe not. I don't know. I don't know if things respawn. I don't think it's really gonna matter. I guess if these things are less threatening than those charger dudes, because those charger dudes, once they're in your grill, they kind of stay there. Come on. Dude, seriously? I'm blowing machine gun ammo for the rest of your health, because I know you can't have too much left. Perhaps I was mistaken. There we go. Oh, I was gonna say, oh, that worries me. Hey there, big guy. No! So what do I have to do, shoot you in the dome? You ain't no necro giant. I've killed bigger in shooters. So am I shooting his head? There's no notification. This dude, all right, is a legitimate threat because he ain't missing. Oh, and he kicks. Noted. Noted. I just needed some health there, buddy boy. What are you doing? Oh, don't tell me. I was gonna say, don't tell me you're gonna pick one of those things up and like use it as a mace. I got cover. Whoa. tendite a falsis prophetis. Alright. So something false prophet. I don't know. Don't speak Latin. There's a reason it's a dead language. Alright, so I just had to, you know, employ the brain meats and, oh hey, cover exists type thing here. Ow! You jerk. Wait a minute, I was gonna say, I can just shoot through this thing. I don't need to worry too much. I don't know where to shoot him. That's the problem. I don't know if I'm actually hurting him. Like, at least on the other enemies, I've got some visual feedback. He's just like, nah, I'm cool. So I'm kind of doming him in the head because that's the giant glow, unless I'm supposed to shoot him on the... I don't know. I need ammo. Ignore me! I don't want to take that health because I've only taken like 20 points of damage. Oh, hey! Maybe. Nah, that's not gonna do anything. Am I hurting you? I have no idea. Absolutely no idea. I'm gonna take that ammo though. Oh, hey! I mean, props to him for... Jeez, okay, now I'll grab the health. Props to him for having some pretty serious, you know, ammo. Ammo weapon systems, I should say. I wonder if I'm supposed to shoot that pack on his back, perhaps? Maybe his weapons? Oh, I think I am supposed to shoot his weapons. Maybe... Yeah, he's making noise every time I shoot him. Maybe that huge glow that they have is supposed to give that away and I'm just a huge idiot. Maybe I should remember the last boss fight that we had where I was supposed to shoot the tubes. Oh, he's mad now. You gonna grab one of these things? I bet you're gonna grab one. What are you doing? Oh, he's summoning ads. I was gonna say, he's got butt bombs. Dear God. Oh wow, okay. So now I'm shooting your armor off, huh? And you can do that, apparently. Any other ads floating around here? No, okay. Alright, I'll blow your plates off. Wonder if I think I have to actually hit them. I don't think my gun is gonna pierce through here. Because, well, maybe it did. I think I took out both of his legs. Well, maybe. Alright, oh. Do that. Oh, hey. That is the weirdest thing. No, it did not pierce through. Okay, I thought it did. I thought it had pierced through and took out his other leg. But apparently they just don't glow when he's doing his minion summoning. Okay. He really doesn't do too much damage, which I'm actually kind of thankful for. That might be because I'm just playing on normal mode, too. I'm sure this game's actually quite challenging on the harder difficulties. Okay, so we got more butt minions. That was a poorly aimed shot. Let's go ahead and pop a couple of those out there to take care of the chattel, I suppose. Alright, so where am I shooting you now? Is he getting ready to drop the base? What is he doing? I am shooting him in the groin now. Alright. We're cold, man. I've been playing Star Wars The Old Republic lately, and I'm running a scoundrel. Did I just beat him? And my favorite ability is the one that lets you nail an enemy in the nuts because of the sound effect it makes. It's horrible. Oh, what a twist. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Zardoz is not amused. Zardoz. Zod. Kneel before Zod! So what am I doing here, game? Am I shooting these guys? Nope. Dude, being a dick. I'm thinking. I think just shooting him's hurting him. Yeah, these things are blowing out. I see. as I freaking put round after round with this railgun into him. Then grab some more bullets. Are you done? Are you done? I got a Chivo, yeah, so I was gonna say, I think I'm done. Jesus. 60, aw man, are we gonna hit 300 this time? I gotta know. Ugh, the game is cruel. Anyways, this is where I'm gonna call it. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will see you all next time, wherein, who knows, until then.